Buddy, hi, assalamualaikum, vanakam, and 大家好. Welcome, welcome, welcome everyone to our second episode of At KitaConnect Tools in Self-Management Live Series. Alright, this is brought to you by UNICEF Malaysia in collaboration with Project ID. My name is Tay Liang Jing. You can also call me Alex, and I'll be the lead for today. And yes, I can see more and more people are joining. Hi, no Shatika. Hello. Hi, Cairo. Hi. Welcome, welcome, welcome. I would like to ask, how are you guys doing? How are you guys doing?
And feel free to hit that love button. Yes, I can see you guys are pumping love. Hi, Misa. Hi. Yeah. Hi, Figaro. Can see you give a thumbs up. Hi, everybody. You have Jonah here with us to make this session more interesting for everybody. Thank you, Jonah, for being here. So today's session is about time management. Last episode, we looked at how much time we actually have and where our time really goes, right? And through that, we know that time is very, very precious. Now that we know time is very precious, how are we going to manage our time better? That is what this session is about. Right? Now, for this session, you will need a paper. It can be A4 paper, it can be recycled paper, a pencil or a pen for you to write. So if you have prepared this, give me a thumbs up in the chat, right? While waiting for everyone to prepare, I would like to say hi to KK. Say hi to Nastra from N, Martin. Hi, Songji. This episode is about time management. So please prepare a paper and a pen because we will do an activity. Right. Okay, now I would like to ask everyone here, what are the challenges you face in managing your time? Apakah cabaran anda ketika menguruskan masa anda? Right? What are the challenges you face? You can share it in the chat, and we are going to try something interesting today. I'm going to open this IG live for every one of you guys here. So if you would like to share verbally with our friends in this IG live, what are the challenges you face in managing your time, you can press the request to join IG live button at the bottom of the screen. There is a camera with a plus icon. So feel free to hit that button and you can join this IG Live. But just want to remind you to be mindful when you are sharing, be respectful when you are sharing, right? Oh, I can see in the chat, first thing, procrastination is the biggest challenge in managing your time. Okay, very true, very true. And then always overtime. Meaning is you always need more time than you expected. Can you finish time? Okay. Yep, that's very true. That's very true. Thank you all for sharing your challenges in managing your time. I'm going to share a little tool for you to manage your time, right? And to use this tool, we have to understand the difference between urgent and important. What do you think is the difference between urgent and important? Can you share with us? You can also press the request to join button and button to come online and share with us. What is the difference between urgent and important? What do you think? Apa maksudnya urgent? Apa maksudnya important? Is there a difference? Are they the same? Let me see in the chat. Ah, I can see more and more people are joining. Hi, Johanna. Hi, Colleen. Hi, Aram. So good to have you guys here. Okay. This is a session on time management, and the current discussion topic that we are having is what is the difference between urgent and important. I have it written down in my on my paper here. You can jot it down on your paper too. Urgent means that immediate action. If something is urgent, then you will need to take immediate action. Right? Meaning, you kena buat, kena ambil tindakan secepat mungkin. For important, if something is important, then mean that thing will help you achieve your goals or give you results. Right? So that is the difference between urgent and important. Right? Urgent means you need to take immediate action. Important related to your goals or results. Why we need to know this? Kenapa? Now, let's draw a box, a big box. And then inside the box, divide it into small, four small squares. Alright, so let's draw it on our paper and pen out. So for those who have just joined, grab a pen or pencil and a paper. Let's draw the box. Alright? Because we are discussing about time management, right? And on the left side of the box, I want you to write important and not important. Right? On the top, this would be urgent and not urgent. On the left, write important and not important. On the top, write urgent. Right? If you are good, give me a thumbs up. Yeah, if you have done drawing and writing, please give a thumbs up in the chat, right? Yeah. For those who have just joined, they are doing pelik kan, kenapa draw this box. We are doing an activity to learn about how to manage our time better. Huh? And this is the activity that we are currently doing. At the box, on the left, let's write important. On the top, now, I would like to ask all of you, what do we put in these boxes? How do we know what activities or what kind of work to put in these boxes? Right? Let's look at this first box over here. Urgent and important. Can you guys share with us what does this box mean? What does this box mean? What does urgent and what does both urgent and important mean? What does that tell us? Can you guys share in the chat? Or you can also press the request to join button below to share. What does this box mean? Yeah, I can see Daniel. Hi, Daniel. Hi, hello. Yeah, anyone would like to share? What is the meaning of this box? When it's both urgent and also important, what does that mean? Figaro said that we have to do it now. Yeah, we have to do it now. Wow, Figaro, you got the answer. Ta-da. Yes, I'm gonna stick this here. For the activities in here, that means we need to do it now. All right? Yes, because it is both urgent, which needs immediate and also important, it will align with your goal, help you achieve results. Right? What about the second box? Important, but not urgent. What does this box mean? What does this box mean? Important and not urgent. Yeah. Hi, Suna. We are talking about time management and we are discussing about this time management tool. We know that in this box, we need to do it now. What about this box? Important and not urgent. What does this box mean? Figaro shared, we can take time to do it. HX Na said that we can do it later. What do you guys think? Yeah, so for me, the answer will be to schedule it. Yes, all right. So it is not urgent, so you don't have to do it now. You don't have to quickly take immediate action, but it helps you achieve your goals. So you still have to do it, so you schedule it. Very nice, guys. I love what you have shared. And that's what we want. Keep just sharing what do you think, all right? There's no right or wrong answer. What about this third box over here? It is urgent, but not important. Apa maksud ni? What do you think this box means? Urgent, but not important. What does it mean? You might be wondering, right? Is there something like, isn't it like urgent, must be important? Yeah, try to share. What do you think this box means? Urgent, tetapi not important. Yeah, let me see. Anyone share in the chat? I can see more and more. Hi, Ronaldo, Malik. Figaro said that. Do it later also. Does this one do it now, right? This one do it later, right? Yeah, okay. Yep, I agree. Do it later, but it is urgent. It's urgent. Can you do it later? Hi, Sabria. Yeah, we are discussing about this time management tool. So feel free to share. And we are sharing what it means. And then we have in this box. Feel free to share what do you know about this box. Urgent and not important. This box means, right, you need to take immediate action, but it doesn't really matter to you. It's not important to you. It doesn't help you achieve your goal, right? So, usually, you can ask yourself, can you delegate it? Meaning, can you ask someone else to do it? Can someone else do it for you? Right? Because it's urgent, right? But actually, it's not that important for you. Yeah. All right? Yeah. What about the last box? Not urgent and not urgent. What does this box mean? What about it is you don't have to take immediate action and it is something that is not related to your goals or results? What does this box mean? What do you mean? Yes. Yeah, I can see you guys. We can delay it. Yes. You can leave it for later, right? So we can put it aside, right? We can put it aside first. Yeah, very good. That is the basic meaning of each box, right? So by knowing what to put in the box, then we can know what we should do it first, do it now. What is something that we need to schedule it? What is something that we can ask someone else to do it? What are something that we can put it aside first and don't have to do it first, right? Now, can you give me an example for the first box? What are some of the activities, apa contoh-contoh aktiviti atau kerja yang kita kena do it now? Kena buat secepat mungkin. Boleh bagi contoh tak? And I would like to also invite children to join our IG live by clicking the request to join button and share what are some of the things for you that is urgent and important that you need to do it now. Yeah. Are there any examples? Feel free to share in the chat or join this IG live and share with us. I can see homework. Yeah. Yes, that's correct. Because homework helps to achieve good results, right? Then homework, you also need to pass up before the deadline too. Oh, I also see shower. Yeah. Shower is very important. But is it okay if you don't do it right now first? Is it really urgent? It depends, right? Yeah. If you are really dirty and you really need to go out, then it's quite good, right? But not always urgent. Any other examples? When you share, you not only learn more, but your friends can learn from you also. The example that I have here is quite similar to one shared by Figaro just now, which is the assignment due tomorrow. Yes. Ah, you can see Figaro also said shower is not urgent but important, right? Yes, exactly, because your personal hygiene, cleanliness is important because it affects your health, right? Yes. Hi, Deshan. Okay, what about... hi, Hilmi. Okay, what about this second box? Can you guys give me some example? Something that is not urgent, but important. Not urgent means you don't need to die-die do it now, but it is important. It helps you achieve your goals. It helps give you results. Can you give an example of the activities? Moonchild said eat. Okay. Eat, that's correct. Because you need to make sure you have enough nutrients. Yeah. Pastikan you kenyang, ada nutrisi. Buy groceries. Okay. I agree. Relaxing your mind. Yes. Yes. To have a healthy mind, relaxed mind is important. What else, guys? Yes, keep it coming. What are the examples that are not urgent and important? The one I have here is there are two things. Number one is workout, right? Similar to eating, relaxing your mind, you need to have a healthy body and mind. And also, goal setting. It's important to have goals, right? Yeah, but it is not urgent. But it's definitely important. I can see Husna, Husna, said who knows? Yeah, yes, I agree. Asasi Alia Cat Shower. Exactly. Yes. Do you know it's help you achieve your academic goals, right? Yeah. And shower, make sure your body clean and healthy. Now let's move on to the next one. What are something that is urgent but not important? What are something that is urgent and not important? And just to let you guys know, based on the responses that you see just now, you can see we are all different. Someone might think something is important, someone might think it is not, and it is totally normal and correct. Because what's important depends on your goals. And we all have different goals, right? So this time management tool is for you. Right? It doesn't have to be follow others. So I can see, take notes of good. Take notes, it's urgent, but maybe you feel like it's not that important. Okay, what about others? Other than, contoh, activity, untuk, otak ini. What are something that you need to take immediate action, but not important? Return book to library. Very specific, I like it. Because if you are late, you're going to dunder, kan? Yes, there will be a penalty. Yeah, correct? But it doesn't exactly help you achieve any goal. Okay. What else is urgent and not important? The one that I have here is something that is called interruptions. Yes. Urgent. Not important, interruption. So for example, when you are revising or you are doing work, and then you got this call or got this message, someone needs your help to do something. But that something is actually not that important for you, right? But the person calling you because it's urgent, right? Yeah. So this kind of interruption, right? Or something, or maybe at your house when you are doing revision, and then your sibling or your parent ask you to help with something, right? So these are all urgent, not that important, right? Ladies and gentlemen, we are at the last box. What are some activities that are not urgent and not important? Apakah contoh? Yang not urgent, dan not important. Things that we need to put it aside. Anything? Any example? And feel free to tap the request to join icon at below, the camera with the plus icon, to come and share with your friends also, right? Or you can share in the comments. The i5, the playing game, okay? Play game, shared by Hot Potato, okay? I'm wondering, are there anything else? And what if I say playing game actually helps you relax? I also see watching TV. Yes, I agree. Playing game. Watching TV, you don't actually help you achieve your goal, right? And at the same time, it is not something that you really have to do right now. Right? Yes. Very good, guys. Thank you for sharing all of that. What I have here is scrolling social media. Yeah. This is also another example that actually doesn't help you achieve your goal and something that you don't have to really do right now. Now, thanks for all the sharing, guys. I hope through this activity, you know more about this time management tool. Now, you can use these boxes and put in activities and work that you would like to do for this coming 7 days, this week. Right? Try to identify which boxes and then follow which one you should do it now, which one you should schedule it, right? Which one you should ask others to do it, which one you should put it aside, right? By knowing this, then you can know what to do with your time and how to use your time for the right work and right activity. Okay? Now, we want to share what you have done also. How? If you have draw these boxes and put in the activity, take a picture, upload to your IG stories, and tag UNICEF Malaysia and project ID, right? And show your friend, and we'll try our best to reshare your IG story with the time management tool that you have learned, right? Yeah. Now, I would like to remind you all, in order to know what is important, you need to know what are your goals, right? Kalau kamu nak tahu apakah penting untuk anda, kamu kena tahu apakah visi, apakah impian anda, kan? So that is why next Wednesday, same time, 8:30 PM, we are going to have another IG Live session goals, right? So please make sure you stay tuned on UNICEF Malaysia and Project ID. So we are going to have another IG Live session next Wednesday night, right? And I would like to close this session with, hey, this is just one of the way. There are so many other ways and so many other applications that you can use to manage your time better. For example, you can try Notion. And what are some of the other applications and websites that you use to manage your time? Can you guys share in the chat? Yeah. Personally, I use Microsoft to do this, to actually manage my time. Yeah. The reason why we need to use all these tools is because the most important tasks sometimes are not the most urgent. But we tend to let the urgent tasks dominate our life and we forget about the important tasks. So it is very important to know what things are important, what things are urgent, which is you can do it using this tool. And then let's focus on the important things that we need to do. Yeah, because ultimately those are the things that help you achieve your goal. Right? Yeah. So that is it for this session. I am so grateful for those of you who have joined from the beginning until now. I hope you are able to manage your time better. And don't forget to tune in again next Wednesday night, because we are going to talk about goal seeking. Right? So that's all for episode 2 of at KitaConnect Tools in Self-Management Live Series. See you all again. Take care. Stay safe. Bye bye.